In today's NVIDIA RAPIDS data science demo, we're going to show a 72 times performance increase of NetworkX. NetworkX is the most popular graph analysis library. We're going to show this speed up performance using two datasets, Zachary's Karate Club, a small but classic dataset, but then more importantly, US patent citations, which has millions of nodes and edges. The two algorithms we're going to showcase are Betweenness Centrality and also PageRank, the original Google search algorithm. We're going to do all this performance analysis and speed up with NVIDIA RAPIDS directly in Google Colab. Google Colab comes with NetworkX and NVIDIA RAPIDS pre-installed. As a matter of fact, in the description below, you'll find a link to the code that we're going to run through. Let's get started. NetworkX is the most popular graph analysis library, and for good reason. It has a very friendly open source community, a simple API, and well-written documentation. The trade-off was performance, but in version 3.0, the concept of a backend was introduced. A backend allows you to override the pure Python implementation, and NVIDIA RAPIDS developed the KuGraph backend for NetworkX. If you go to the documentation for the various algorithms, like the ones we're going to cover today, Betweenness Centrality, and you scroll down to the bottom of the documentation for that algorithm, you can see which ones have backend implementation. So there's KuGraph GPU acceleration, and also for the PageRank algorithm, we'll scroll down to the bottom and see that KuGraph also GPU accelerates PageRank. Now, what's nice about Google Colab is that NetworkX and NVIDIA RAPIDS comes pre-installed. So if we run this command here, we can see NetworkX and NVIDIA RAPIDS KuGraph pre-installed into Google Colab. Zachary's Karate Club, our first data set, is part of NetworkX. It's small enough. And there we've confirmed we have 3.4 to make sure we have the latest, fastest version. But we'll go ahead and get Zachary's Karate Club. We'll store it in capital G. This is the standard variable name for a graph in NetworkX, similar to DF for data frame and pandas or polars. And nice simple API, we'll go ahead and plot the nodes, edges, and labels. And there we have the 34 nodes and connections, 78 connections for Zachary's Karate Club. Now that we have our data set, we'll go ahead and perform our first algorithm here, Betweenness Centrality. Like I said in the beginning, very clean API. Betweenness Centrality. We'll go ahead and add those results to the graph. And if we take a quick peek at the results here, we can see the Betweenness Centrality for node 0 is the highest at 0.4. And the second highest is node 33 with 0.3. And the rest, we can presume, are the students with much lower values. We'll go ahead and plot it. And before the plot was all purple nodes, but now that we have Betweenness Centrality calculated, we can see that node 0 with the highest value is the most yellow, followed by 33. And there's a few other nodes that have a little bit of Betweenness Centrality. So we can presume this is an owner or a teacher. This is an owner or a teacher, and the rest are the students in Zachary's Karate Club. Next, we'll cover the PageRank algorithm from Google, the original search algorithm. This scores the number of links to a node, and then the links from that node carry a higher weight, as you can see here on this Wikipedia page. We'll go ahead and run that. The function is, of course, called PageRank, and we'll add the scores from that PageRank to the graph and plot it. Again, you can see the teacher or the owner are 0 and 33. They have more yellow in the node, and then all of the students in Zachary's Karate Club are more purple. Our next data set is US patent citations. It has millions of nodes and connections. It is hosted on the SNAP Stanford datasets. I'm going to load it first with NVIDIA RAPIDS off. We're going to load it into a data frame, and that's going to take about 4.5 seconds. But if I run this magic command, this is the same code. This code right here is the same as this code right here. and it's going to run about 3 times faster with RAPIDS on. All right, now that we have our data set into a data frame, into a pandas data frame, we now need to load it into a NetworkX graph. This is going to take a minute. I'm going to go ahead and speed up the video right here. All right, that data set is loaded into a NetworkX graph. And if we go ahead and verify, we can see that we have 3.8 million nodes. And there we have it. And now for the fun part. Now we're going to take our large graph with millions of nodes, millions of connections, and we're going to perform that same graph analysis between the centrality and page rank on this very large data set. And we're going to do it with NVIDIA RAPIDS off to begin with. And then we're going to do it with NVIDIA RAPIDS on. We're going to set one configuration and run the exact same graph analysis and look at the performance boost. The first thing is we have to turn on caching. Caching will cache the graph in its various formats for the various algorithms. I'll explain more in a second if you're not familiar. And to make sure that we don't have NVIDIA RAPIDS on, we're going to configure zero backends. The first thing we're going to do is run this betweenness centrality, and we're going to set k equal to 1. This is going to set, this parameter is going to use sampling. If we were trying to run this algorithm on all millions of nodes and edges, it would take hours, maybe days, but we're going to use k equals 1 to get this started. I'll go ahead and pause the video here, and we'll come back when it's done in about a minute. All right, so that took 1 minute and 1 second for betweenness centrality. We'll go ahead and run the page rank as well. And again, I'll pause the video and we'll come back when it's done in about a minute and a half. All right, so that took 100 seconds, a minute and 40 seconds. We're gonna turn NVIDIA RAPIDS on. We can do this in a system environment variable, or we can do it right here in Python. We're going to say use cuGraph. The way these backends work is if it's going to check this list of backends, and if it's implemented, it's going to run it in that implementation. If it is not, it's going to fall back to the pure Python implementation. Remember, we turned on caching up here, and this caching is going to reuse a graph. So if you have dynamic data, you do not want to use this cache. In our case, this is static data. And remember, between this centrality with NVIDIA RAPIDS off was 61 seconds. And including the creation of the cache, we have 25 seconds. Now that we have a cache, it's going to take about 1 second, 1.5 seconds. So this is 70 times 70 speed up for between this centrality with it already cached. Again, we're gonna do this with PageRank. So PageRank with NVIDIA RAPIDS off took 100 seconds, a minute and 40 seconds. And with NVIDIA RAPIDS on, it's going to take, including the cache creation, including converting that graph into a graph usable by PageRank, it's going to take about 30 seconds. But again, just like between the centrality, once it is cached, it will take under 2 seconds. So it should be done here. We can see 30 seconds, 31 seconds with the cache, 1.42 seconds. So time 70 speed up with RAPIDS on. And this is fast enough that we don't have to use a small sample size. So above we had to say k equals 1 with NVIDIA RAPIDS off. You get a faster execution, but you lose accuracy. With a larger sample, we gain accuracy. And even with this times 100 sample size, we're still at 6 seconds. So that's RAPIDS on and RAPIDS off for both between the centrality and PageRank. There we have it, NVIDIA RAPIDS NetworkX time 70 speed up without changing any code, just a single backend configuration. We did two data sets, Zachary's Karate Club, just for a demonstration of the two algorithms, Betweenness Centrality and PageRank. And then we used US patent citations data with millions of nodes, millions of connections, and we saw that time 70 acceleration with NVIDIA RAPIDS. We did it all in Google Colab, where NetworkX and NVIDIA RAPIDS come pre-installed. In the description below, you'll see a link to this notebook so you can run it yourself. Cheers and happy coding.